La paz de Cristo sea con ustedes. May the peace of Christ be with you. Los saludo en el precioso y poderoso nombre de Cristo Jesús, Rey de Reyes y Señor de Señores. We will listen to the word of the Lord today in Matthew chapter 8, verses 14 to 22. Escucharemos y leeremos la palabra de Dios en Mateo, capítulo 8, versículos 14 al 22. Dice así la palabra de Dios, thus says the word of the Lord. Now when Jesus had come into Peter's house, he saw his wife's mother lying sick with a fever. So he touched her hand, and the fever left her, and she arose and served them. When evening had come, they brought to him many who were demon-possessed, and he cast out the spirits with a word, and healed all who were sick. That it might be fulfilled which was spoken by Isaiah the prophet, saying, He himself took our infirmities and bore our sicknesses. And when Jesus saw great multitudes about him, he gave a command to depart to the other side. Then a certain scribe came to him and said, Teacher, I will follow you wherever you go. And Jesus said to him, Foxes have holes, and birds of the air have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to lay his head. Then another of his disciples said to him, Lord, let me first go and bury my father. But Jesus said to him, Follow me, and let the dead bury their own dead. Fue Jesús a casa de Pedro y vio a la suegra de éste postrada en cama, con fiebre. Entonces tocó su mano y la fiebre le dejó. Ella se levantó y lo servía. Al caer la noche le llevaron muchos endemoniados y con la palabra echó fuera a los demonios y sanó a todos los enfermos, para que se cumpliese lo dicho por el profeta Isaías. Él mismo tomó nuestras enfermedades y llevó nuestras dolencias. Viéndose Jesús rodeado de mucha gente, dio orden de pasar al otro lado. Se le acercó un escriba y le dijo, Maestro, te seguiré a donde quiera que vayas. Jesús le dijo, Las zorras tienen guardias y las aves del cielo nidos, pero el Hijo del Hombre no tiene dónde recostar su cabeza. Otro de sus discípulos le dijo, Señor, permíteme que vaya primero y entierre a mi padre. Jesús le dijo, Sígueme, deja que los muertos entierren a sus muertos. Esta es la palabra de Dios, this is the word of the Lord. Please join me in prayer. Amantísimo Dios y Padre Celestial, gracias Señor por tu santa palabra. Te rogamos Señor que llenes nuestro corazón con ella y que tu Espíritu Santo obre de acuerdo a tu santísima voluntad. Lord and Heavenly Father, thank you for your precious holy word. Teach us to delight in it, Lord. Now, Lord, as we listen to your word read and proclaimed, we pray for your Holy Spirit to continue sanctifying us, transforming us. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. El título del sermón en este día es Seguidores del Mesías, Followers of the Messiah. A certain scribe said to Jesus, I will follow you wherever you go. This statement leads us to ask, what is a follower? Algunas personas son seguidores de algún artista famoso o de alguna persona experta en algo. Algunos son seguidores de un partido político o de algún líder político o religioso. A follower is an adherent or devotee to a particular person, cause, or activity. We are talking about more than simply following someone on Facebook or Twitter. Un seguidor es alguien que admira, aprende e imita a la persona, idea o causa que sigue. A follower is devoted to what or whom he or she follows. Therefore, we must be careful of who we follow. En el Evangelio de Mateo, los capítulos 8 y 9, nos relatan varios de los milagros que realizó nuestro Señor Jesús. En este caso vemos cómo sana a la suegra de Pedro y cómo realizó también varios milagros. Los milagros de Jesús son la evidencia de que el Espíritu Santo está sobre él sin límite alguno. The miracles of Jesus are the evidence that he is the promised Messiah. Remember when John the Baptist's disciples came to Jesus and asked if he was the one they were waiting for, or should they wait for another one, for someone else? What did Jesus answer? Do you remember? He said, go tell him, go tell John the Baptist, go tell John what you hear. Go tell him what you see. The blind see, and the lame walk. The lepers are cleansed, and the deaf hear. The dead are raised, and the poor have the gospel preached to them. Los milagros que realizó Jesús eran la evidencia de que Él es el Mesías prometido, uno con Dios y Dios mismo. Therefore, to be a follower of Jesus meant to be a follower of the promised Messiah, not a follower of a mere human being with great ideals, not a follower of a political or military leader, not the follower of a great teacher, but a follower of God himself. El escriba que se le acercó a Jesús y que quería seguir a Jesús, él obviamente no entendía quién era Jesús. El seguir al Mesías prometido demanda una entrega total, demanda un rendimiento completo a él. Afterwards, a disciple said to him, let me first go and bury my dad, my father. And Jesus answered him, follow me and let the dead bury their dead. Christ's call to follow him demands a complete surrender of all our being to him. Nothing or no one is to be more important than he is in our lives. Nada ni nadie debe ser más importante que él en nuestras vidas. Nada, nada ni nadie. Su llamado demanda un rendimiento total. Los creyentes en Cristo deben ser no nada más creyentes, también deben ser seguidores de Cristo. O sea que Cristo debe ser más importante que nada o que nadie en sus vidas. Déjenme decir eso una vez más. Los creyentes en Cristo también deben ser seguidores. Nada ni nadie debe ser más importante que Cristo en nuestras vidas. Muchas veces nos alejamos de Él y no le seguimos como debemos, como deberíamos. También, lamentablemente, hay muchos creyentes que no siguen al Señor realmente. As believers in Jesus Christ, we must also be followers of Him. To be a follower is to learn and embrace His teachings. Learn and embrace His teachings. To be a follower is to do what He tells us to do. What? To do what he tells us to do. To be a follower is to do everything for his glory and honor. To be a follower of Jesus is to learn and embrace his teachings, to do what he tells us to do it all for his glory and honor. Como seguidores de Cristo Jesús, el Mesías prometido, hemos de recibir y aprender sus enseñanzas. Hemos de obedecer sus mandamientos y hemos de hacer todo para su gloria y su honra. Todo con amor para Cristo. My friends, our country, the United States of America, has become extremely conflicted and divided. Everyone seems to be against each other. People are offensive. We have become extremely offensive. And at the same time, people get very easily offended. Any little thing offends people. Politicians from all sides seem to spend all their time, all their energy, all their efforts, and the people's money in destroying their opponents. ¿Qué debe hacer la iglesia en estos momentos de tanta división en nuestro país? What must the church do in these conflicting and divisive times? ¿Qué debe hacer el creyente? La palabra de Dios nos recuerda el día de hoy que hemos de seguir al Mesías prometido y no a un partido político, no una ideología, no a un ser humano. Jesus Christ is the head of the church. He, through his holy word, is our only authority. The church should thoughtfully, prayerfully, respectfully, and lovingly influence politics. Let me say that again. The church should thoughtfully, respectfully, lovingly, prayerfully influence politics. But the church should not be influenced by politics. For Jesus Christ alone is head of the church. We are followers of the Messiah. Somos seguidores del Mesías. Jesucristo, nuestro Señor y cabeza de la iglesia. A Él sea la gloria hoy y siempre. May the glory be. The glory is. May it be. Always. To Jesus Christ, the head of the church. Amen. God loves you, and so do I. Bye-bye.